Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So one of these merchants on Amazon sent me these LED lights to review. So that's what we're gonna go over today. I'm gonna actually take it, unbox it, go over the materials that it's made of and how it works. And I'm gonna actually test the light levels and take some light level measurements installed in my garage here. So stay tuned. So if you guys don't already know, as my day job, I'm actually an electrical engineer. I'm a professional engineer here in Florida, and I specialize in industrial lighting, industrial energy conservation, and helping my clients design and save energy. So, you know, LED lighting is just one of the many components that I do on my daily job anyway. So, you know, I know a little bit of something about lighting. And if you watch some of my other videos where I set up my lighting in my garage here, I've actually got like 45,000 lumens worth of lights off my main lights here, and then I've got another probably like 12,000 lumens on another light over here. So I've got a lot of lumens in my garage already from just my normal daily lighting that I do work in here on. So if you guys don't have something like this at home, or you're just still using your incandescent bulbs or CFL bulbs, this is a great upgrade. It's an easy screw-in upgrade for your garage, so you know it's worth a shot if you know, if you want to try something out and get a little bit more light out of your garage. So as we unbox it, first thing I noticed that this thing comes with, it comes with a little E26 screw-in base. So if you don't have a screw-in already in your ceiling, if you have like an outlet or something, or just need to run a new outlet, this is a perfect mount for it, for you to use. It just screws in two screws inside. It looks like it's got two little screws where you can actually put the wires in, your hot and your neutral, and wire it up. I don't see a ground in here, which I don't think you need a ground for this E26 socket. And the light itself, pretty versatile light. It's one of those that has adjustable wings on it, so you can actually adjust the angle and point in all four directions where you need to go. They've got little set screws and set nuts on each side, so you could hold them tight to where you want them and they don't go anywhere. And one of the things that, it feels like a plastic, but it's actually not a plastic. It's a, if you hit it with a screwdriver or a piece of metal, it bounces like metal. So, but it's lightweight, it's hollow, so it's pretty robust as far as the aluminum wings go. And with all these little fins right here, they actually help the heat dissipate off the LEDs on here. And if you actually look inside the lenses, each one of these, it's got a little cob or a little strip of LED. So there's three going this way, and there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 going that way. So 8 times 3, that's 24. So that's 24 on each of these. So this thing is actually rated at 120 watts and 12,000 lumens. So that's about 100 lumens per watt, which is on par with your LED screw-ins and all that you get these days on the market. They are getting up there as far as lumens per watts go and the technology. Like in the industrial environment where I work and I design for my clients, we're up to like over 200 lumens per watt on those type of fixtures. But those things are really expensive. I mean, those are like $200 to $300 fixtures and you know, they're up to like 20,000 to 30,000 lumens per fixture, where this is more for your garage and your simple DIY at home. So we'll go ahead and hang this up now and we'll test the light levels. So I've got this baby mounted up in the ceiling, as you can see, and I've got all my lights, my general lights right there, the one over here, and then that one back there, all turned off. And this is what my garage looks like with that light. My camera's on manual settings, so the aperture is not even adjusted. So this is the same settings that I was recording with earlier, and this is what my garage looks like with this light under it. So I'm measuring it with my X-Tech light meter. This is the same one I use for work. So we'll go ahead and take the cap off this, kind of put it in that same spot right under the light, and then turn it on to see what we're at. This thing's measuring in at about 34.8 foot candles, which that's in the US measurement for it. If you want to look at the lux is usually about 10 times that. So that's 370 lux. So we'll go switch back to foot candles. So that's 34.5 right there on the backup, and it's still kind of the same. So we weren't really blocking the output. Well, the sensor's over there, so we really weren't blocking it anyways. So that's with the all four flaps just kind of folded down. And as you can tell, you know,
it's straight down, so the walls, as you can see, the shadows and the cutoff on the walls all around the garage. So I'll go ahead and go up there and adjust it, and we'll see how that looks when I adjust the flaps and the light levels. So I adjusted it basically like 30 degrees all around. You can kind of see the cutoff, that square right around the edge of the light where the flaps go up, and you can see the sharp cutoff on it. So that's right now. It's actually lighting up all around the garage much better now as far as the walls go. So it's throwing the light sideways. So here's my workbench and my toolkit, so you see it's much brighter now. And then we'll see the light levels. So obviously with the light flaps turned out more, the light level directly down at it is gonna be a little lower. So it's down to 28.7 foot candles versus the 34.5, 35 foot candles before. So you can see you're gonna compromise the light going down, but you're gonna get much better light distribution around the garage or around the room. So the walls are gonna be lit more. So that's really the trade-off. But you know, with the way that light is, it's very versatile. You can adjust it wherever you need the light. You could adjust two sides, one side, or all sides, you know, wherever you need it as you're working. And you can see I adjusted it pretty well because it's a perfect square cutoff all around the light. So another thing to note as I turned my regular lights back on. So my garage is actually at 4000K, all my lights, and the screw-in light that they sent that I've been reviewing, that one is actually a 5000K, maybe a 5500K. So it's closer to a daylight where mine is like a regular white light. So that's really the big difference in the room as far as that goes. Some people like the 5000K. You know, I'm used to the 4000K because it gives me a much whiter light and less bluish light, and that's really the only difference. But you know, a lot of these lights also come in different color temperatures, so you can just shop around depending on what the manufacturer makes. So after taking these down and actually looking at the specs on the back of these, so what it looks like is these things are actually universal voltage, so they work anywhere from 85 volts up to 265 volts at both 60 and 50 hertz. So they're pretty well universal across the world and can be used in a lot of different countries and places. The color is actually a 65,000 Kelvin, so it was much higher than what I was thinking when it was up there. I think I was thinking it was like 5,000 or 5,500 Kelvin, but these are 65,000. Much more bluer and much more daylighty. As far as the ratings go, so it looks like here's all the different international ratings that these lamp has. And then, like I said earlier, these are 120 watts at a 12,000 lumens.
Hey guys, thanks for tuning in all the way to the end of this video. For all you guys that stayed this far in the video, what I'm gonna do with these two lights that they sent me for the review is I wanna do a giveaway. So once this video hits 1,000 views, I'm gonna give this away to two of my viewers who leave comments on this video. So on this video, just leave me a comment, tell me what you guys run now in your garage or in your closet or in your shed or wherever your workspace is, and if you could use this upgraded light in that garage. Once we hit that 1,000 views, I'll go ahead and do a drawing for two of you viewers. So anyways, if you guys found this video informative and you got some information from it and you learned something, don't forget to like the video. If you haven't done so already, subscribe to your channel. Most of my content is car content, but I usually do these little review videos or technology type videos that relate to what I do, whether it's video editing, photography, or just, you know, lights in the garage where it makes my job easier when I'm working on cars or when you're working on cars. So anyways, I'll talk to you guys next time in the next video.